Modern civilization is addicted to oil. We burn up or otherwise consume some 90 million barrels of the goop every day. That ends up making a mess. According to the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, there are an average of 70 spills every day, mostly insignificant. Every once in a while, we make a spectacular mess, like the punctured Exxon Valdez oil tanker off the coast of Alaska, or BP's blown-out Macondo well at the bottom of the Gulf of Mexico. When humans make a big mess like that, humans try to clean it up. We corral it with booms or burn it off, but whatever we miss ends up getting eaten by microscopic bugs. In fact, bacteria and other microbes are one of the main reasons that BP's Gulf oil spill wasn't a bigger disaster. A big bloom of bugs ate most of the 4.1 million barrels of oil spilled before it could wash into wetlands or tar sea creatures. How big was the bloom? 100 sextillion microbial cells big. Here's how they work. Oil has been a part of life on Earth for eons, and microbes evolved to take advantage of that. Tiny bacterium feast on the oil and gas seeping from the bottom of the seafloor or bubbling to the surface. They're not necessarily fast, but they are thorough, turning loose hydrocarbons into more microbial cells. But microbes don't only eat oil. Plastics, often made from oil, get everywhere too. For example, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is made up of tiny grains of plastic and the occasional grocery bag. It's actually proved to be a hospitable home for plastic-eating microbes and other microscopic life. This new ecosystem has been dubbed the plastosphere. On their own, microbes would probably take eons to clean up our plastic mess. But with synthetic biology, we could tweak these little friends and help speed up that process. We could help them to help us. Scientists have been working on souping up microbes' ability to eat oil for decades. The very first genetically modified organism to be patented was an oil-eating microbe way back in 1980. There's no reason that plastic eaters couldn't be enhanced in the same way. It's obviously better to avoid trashing plastic and dumping oil in the first place. But since we're a messy bunch, it's a good thing we have microbes around to help us clean up. For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, I'm David Biello.